Hello, this is Bern, and if you're in a relationship that feels stagnant, the commitment was initially there, but now you're not sure if you're wasting your time, on today's video, I'm going to share with you 7 often overlooked signs that he'll never propose. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and enter the relationship you crave without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or silly techniques. If this is your first time here, and this is a topic that really interests you, make sure to click the subscribe button so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. Let me first share that the biggest problem you might be in right now is not a situation where you're stuck, where the guy was really excited at the beginning and you saw something more than a boyfriend long term, but he's still your boyfriend months and months out. The biggest problem is that you have no way of identifying how far away you are from the possibility of things moving forward in the direction of your dreams, including marriage and a family. That's part of what you want. So what I want to share with you today is the 7 overlooked signs that I find time and time again in women who stay with guys far longer than they need to, so you can make a better determination as to what's the best way moving forward. Now, this isn't a Cosmo magazine type of article where at the end you'll get a score that if you hit 15, then you leave him, and if you hit 3, then you stay. This is more nuanced than that. So I'll take into account that you're an intelligent human being who can filter what I'm sharing in a nuanced way that allows you to know how far away you are from a situation that's healthy, so you can move forward, including leaving a guy who may not have the capabilities of taking you where you want to go. Before I go there and explain the 7 steps, if you want to take the concepts of this video further than I can share with you in this short time, and you want to understand how you can embody the change, not just intellectually, but in your heart and soul, that you can move things forward and attract the type of relationship and man you want, then hit the first link on the description of this video. You'll find a page that looks like this. Enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to my free training that will help you do just that. The first sign that the guy you're with will never propose, and if he does, it will be a house of pain for you, is a guy who avoids working on his multiple levels of unhealed pain. We all go through challenging situations. We all go through painful times in life, but when you've connected with a guy who has lots of unseen issues, who has experienced trauma or extreme pain and doesn't want to talk about it, doesn't want to heal it, can't ask for help, but the situation that you're in is one where the pain that he's experienced has created enough fears that he doesn't want to move things forward, and until he's willing to look at that pain and release it in some way, work through it, it's highly unlikely that the love he has for you will be enough to move things forward. So if you find a guy who has a lot of unhealed situations in the past and he's unwilling to work through it and get help, that's a big one. I'm starting with this because it's a big one, and so many women feel compelled to be with a guy in part in secret to heal him, and all the love in your heart will not heal certain things in him if he's unwilling to work on them. Number 2, he hasn't figured out yet what he wants out of life, or he's younger than he needs to be to figure that out. Many women connect with guys who are in a life stage that is not mature enough for them to figure out what they want, much less devote themselves to a relationship, which is secondary in many guys' experience from that first challenge. So it's important when you connect to men and when you're in a relationship to find out, is the guy you're with someone who is clear on what he's seeking out of life? Has he stepped into it in any way that allows him to feel more centered, more balanced, and with more confidence to then be able to offer you something better than him confused about what his purpose in life is? Number 3, he can't articulate a thriving vision for marriage. So let's say that you have a very clear idea of what you want, when you want it, you've seen your wedding dress multiple times in your mind, you imagine your wedding, you want a relationship that has a family, and when you talk to him about the future, he's vague and he can't articulate what exciting possibilities exist in a committed monogamous relationship. If he can't figure it out for himself, then he can't figure it out for you. So one sign that the guy you're with isn't really moving forward is he's not seeing the goal at the end of that rainbow. He's confused or scared and has a confused vision of what a connected, committed, lifelong partnership looks like. And the excess of your clarity will not convince him. He has to be able to see it for himself before he can offer it to you. Number four, his reaction of defensiveness when you bring up the topic puts it back on you, meaning it's not that he is unwilling to commit and articulate what he wants, it's that you're too needy. It's not that he is unable to create more conscious commitment, is that you are too tight on the specific goals that you have. So whenever you find a man where the conversation that is one of the most meaningful ones you can have in terms of specifically, precisely, and actionably, not in vague terms, what he's looking out of a relationship with you, and thus you want eventually to move towards the type of life that you want, including marriage, when that conversation can't take place because when he feels the fear of that conversation, he deflects it back as if it's one of your flaws. Like, you are too pushy, you are too needy, you want to constrict his oxygen, so to speak. But it's something that you expect of someone that you've been with for years, then there's a challenge in the way you're seeing things. And that's one clear sign that the vision that you have for marriage ain't happening anytime soon, if at all. Number five, when his fear of losing freedom is greater than his fear of losing you. Every guy and every woman has a definition of what freedom means. For some people, freedom means the ability to be loved and seen at the deepest level and express himself or herself in a way that transcends this world. Where when he or she is far gone from this planet, there's something left behind based on, it's a wake left on that boat based on what he or she shared. Now, when his biggest fear in life is not maybe not meeting his mission or losing someone that he is really connected with, but losing freedom, because the definition of freedom that he has for himself is, I do what I want, when I want, with whom I want, with no explanations needed. If that's the definition of freedom, which, by the way, I think is a little bit too silly, it's a little bit too constricted, if he fears losing freedom more than he fears losing you, then it's highly unlikely that he'll take the steps necessary to move things forward. And how do you know that a guy fears losing freedom? When his daily life and his daily plans and the way he conducts himself is far more selfish than generous. Number six, he knows you will hang on by a thin thread regardless of what he does or doesn't do. Maybe you've been burnt in the past. Maybe you're more into him than he's into you. Maybe you're really afraid of being alone. Maybe he gets a sense that if he were to leave you, that you'd be somewhat devastated and unable to move forward in a way that's healthy and in a way that allows you to thrive again. Well, he'll give you just enough to where you won't say, I'm out, until you say, I'm out. So part of the reason why he hasn't moved forward is, I mean, it could be that it's too soon in the relationship, and that's a healthy reason for not moving forward. But when multiple years have gone by and there's a clear understanding of what needs to take place and he's still dragging his feet, then more likely than not, he knows that you'll stay with him even if he doesn't go forward, meaning your standard of commitment to that level of relationship is not as strong as it needs to be. Otherwise, he would have either stepped up or stepped down and allowed you the possibility to move forward. So this one's on you. If he knows that you're going to stay there regardless of what he does, you might have to be clear on your specific needs and the consequences of those needs not being met. Number seven, he confuses interdependence with a weakness. Maybe the highest value that he's going for is independence. Now, independence is better than dependence, but interdependence, in my way of looking at things, is better than independence. Why? Because you'll be able to do so much more in life if you're able to connect and grow and mesh your greatest strengths with somebody else's greatest strengths. Now, not everybody feels or thinks this way. My guess, my dear, is if you're watching my videos, is that at some level, you know that being alone is better than being with the wrong person, but being with the right person is better than being alone. So my recommendation is, if you connect with a guy who's really confused or who is off the idea that depending in a healthy way, connecting in a healthy way with somebody else is a weakness, that you understand that to commit to a lifelong process of doing that is something that's going to be really, really hard. Hope this is something that is helpful and insightful to you in some way. If it is, as I shared earlier, and you want to take this further, and you want to understand how not to just get stuck in this type of relationship, but how to get the emotional courage to move forward and get what you want, then go to the first link in the description of this video, click on that link, and enter in my email, and you'll immediately redirected to my free training to show you how to move beyond intellectual understanding and into the embodiment of this work. If you like this video, please click like or thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. If you hit the little bell, you'll be notified of new episodes. Let me know in a comment what's the biggest takeaway that you got from this. And last but not least, if you've been doing everything under the sun, watching videos, mine and other people's, reading books, doing webinars, getting shaman cleansings, doing the law of attraction, going to therapy, no matter what you're doing, you're still stuck in this type of painful relationship or not able to attract the type of man you want, you might significantly benefit from hand-holding and help. And if you think that I might be able to help you, click on the second link in the description of this video. If we're fit to work together, we'll connect. I'll share with you how that works, and then we can move forward with getting you what you want in a fraction of the time. Thank you so much for connecting with me, for allowing me into your home and heart. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.